Hello everybody. Today we're going to talk about a component most of our cars have, the mass airflow sensor, or the MAF. This part monitors the amount of air flowing into the engine, which helps the engine control module to adjust the fuel injection for optimum performance. Due to its importance, the MAF sensor will cause a variety of engine issues if it starts malfunctioning. So in this video, we will learn how the MAF sensor works and go over the most common symptoms of a faulty one. But before we do that, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification button to get all the latest updates from our channel. First, let's take a brief moment to see how the MAF sensor works. The MAF sensor in every car is located between the air filter and the engine intake manifold. Here, it measures the amount of air flowing towards the engine, and it does this in a quite simple way. Inside the sensor, there is a thin metal wire. The ECU sends a current through this wire, which heats it up and causes it to generate certain electrical resistance. But as the air passes around this heated wire, it cools it down and lowers the resistance. The differences in these values are monitored by the ECU, which uses this data to assess the airflow and consequently adjust the fuel injection. Now, let's go over some usual and common symptoms. The first and most common symptom of a bad MAF sensor is a check engine light on your dashboard. The engine control module monitors all sensors in the car to ensure that everything is okay. If an engine sensor sends an incorrect signal, the ECM will trigger the check engine light. Therefore, if your MAF sensor is faulty and sends a wrong information to the ECM, you'll probably have this warning light on your dashboard. However, the engine control module doesn't always recognize a faulty MAF sensor, so you may still have a defective one even if the engine light is not on. But even if it is, you should first check the diagnostic trouble codes with the OBD2 scanner and see what will pop up. Next, you might have performance issues. Your engine needs a perfect air-fuel mixture in the combustion chamber for optimal performance. A faulty MAF sensor can cause a too rich or too lean mixture, and it can cause many strange performance issues. Some of the issues you may experience here are slow acceleration, misfires, hesitation, rough or jerky acceleration, hard start or long cranking, and rough idle. However, these issues could also be caused by something else, but it's definitely a high chance that a faulty MAF sensor is causing them. One thing you can do here is to unplug the MAF sensor's connector. This will cause your car to run on predefined values instead of those provided by the MAF sensor. Furthermore, there may be a lot of black or gray smoke coming from the exhaust. This is a strong sign that your engine is getting too much fuel compared to air. Therefore, if you realize that lately there is more smoke coming from your exhaust pipe than usual, there is a significant risk that your engine runs too rich. This is something a bad MAF sensor could easily cause. Next, there is a fuel consumption, which may become higher or lower. As we talked about before, this is because a bad MAF sensor will mess with the air-fuel mixture. So if you see that your car's fuel consumption has gone up or down lately, it's a strong sign that the MAF sensor is bad. If you notice reduced fuel consumption, you may think that is a good thing, but it can actually damage your engine, which can make it more expensive in the long run. Lastly, you might have rich or lean trouble codes. If you have a code scanner and you see some error codes related to rich or lean fuel mixture, it is very likely that it is caused by a bad MAF sensor. However, these can be also caused by other problems, so it is important to make a complete diagnosis before replacing any parts. Next, let's see how to clean a dirty MAF sensor. Issues linked to the MAF sensor oftentimes happen due to the dirt buildups of the MAF sensor's hot wire. This particle accumulation over time results in poor performance of the sensor, which gives the ECM faulty readings. Luckily, cleaning the MAF sensor is in most cases a straightforward job that usually fixes the issue. Just remove the MAF sensor from the engine bay and carefully clean the sensor's hot wire with an electronic cleaner. However, the sensor's hot wire is very sensitive and you can easily damage it, therefore you don't want to touch it with your hands or anything else. Just spray it and let it dry, it should be enough. Reinstall the MAF sensor, clean the trouble codes and go for a drive to see if there is any difference. If the car runs better, congratulations, you saved yourself a lot of money and time. In the end, we'll go over the diagnostic procedure. The MAF sensor is often quite expensive to replace, so it's important to make a correct diagnosis before replacing it. Luckily, diagnosing a faulty MAF sensor is usually relatively easy if you know what to look for. But to do this correctly, you must have the right values for your specific car and its engine, which you can find in a repair manual. So here are some steps to take if you think your MAF sensor is bad. Step 1. Fire up the engine and unplug the MAF sensor. If the engine runs better after this, it's likely the MAF sensor is bad. Step 2. Check the MAF sensor's connector and look for corrosion. If there is any, clean it off with an electric cleaner. Step 3. Clean the MAF sensor as we discussed before. Reinstall it and drive for a while to see if this fixed the issue. Step 4. Check the intake or boost pipes for any leaks. A bad MAF sensor has the same symptoms as an intake leak, so you'll want to look for any signs of loose hoses or other damage to the intake. Step 5. Connect an OBD2 scanner and turn the key to the ignition and check the live data from the MAF sensor. It should read zero. Next, step 6. Fire up the engine and check the MAF sensor values again. It should go up when you rev the engine and down as the engine RPM drops. If the value is stable, there is either something wrong with your diagnostic tool, MAF sensor, or the wiring. Lastly, step 7. Check the sensor's wiring with a multimeter tool. Most MAF sensors require two signal wires, power and the ground to the ECM. This, however, may differ between the cars, so you want to check a repair manual or wiring diagram to be sure. If the values given by your multimeter are different from those specified by the manufacturer, you probably have a wiring issue.
That's all for today. Now you should know how to spot a bad MAF sensor and fix the problem. If you liked this video and it helped you, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. But if you didn't, something other than a faulty MAF may be causing your issues. To continue troubleshooting, visit our website or visit our community forum and leave us a question there.